So if your computer won't boot, before attempting to do any repairs that could potentially lose your files, let me show you how you can access those documents and back them up before attempting any repairs or taking it into a repair shop. In a previous video, going back quite a few years when I started the channel, I have a popular video that actually showed you how to remove the hard drive physically out of the computer, hooking it up using special cables, then you can access the data and copy and paste it. In this tutorial, what I'd like to show you is how you can recover your files from a computer that won't boot without having to physically take the hard drive out of the computer and without requiring any special cables. All you need is a USB stick or a blank CD and just a few minutes of your time. So stick around. So the first thing you want to do is create a bootable CD or USB. The USBs are faster and easy, and they're very cheap to purchase one. If you haven't already got a free one from some seminar, lots of people give them away. So in this other video I created up here, I show you how to create this boot disk. So now I'm going to show you how to use that disk that we created. So if you're not sure how to create a Linux boot disk, then check out that video and then we can continue from here. You have your USB ready. We're going to move on with booting from the USB drive. Now, a quick note is with the newer computers, it's a little difficult to be able to access the boot menu. So it may be forcing it to boot from the C drive, and we want to get it to boot from the USB drive. So if it doesn't automatically look at that, you'd have to tell it to do it. And if you don't see a press delete or press F12 to boot the computer from when it first turns on, you may need to do some other things around that. It's a lot easier if Windows is already working. With Windows 10, you can hold down the shift key while going to start and restart, and then you'll have an option where it says to choose a UEFI device or go into the UEFI settings, and it'll reboot the computer into the BIOS. And then from the BIOS, you can then tell it to change the boot order or temporarily choose a boot device. In my case, I had to go into the BIOS. So you can see from my BIOS here, at the bottom of the BIOS screen, there is a boot device, or to change boot order. And when I click that, I've got a list of boot devices. I can choose my USB device, and then it begins to boot from that USB. Once it starts booting from the USB, if you created it using Yummy multi-boot device, which I showed you in that other video I linked to earlier, this is what it looks like here. It comes up with the menu options. We want to go into the Linux distributions, and we'll see the Linux distribution that we got. You could have downloaded any one. It doesn't matter which flavor of Linux you have. In my case, I chose this Xubuntu, and it's going to continue booting from there. So as it starts booting from the Linux device here, we can see it booting into the Linux distribution that you've downloaded and created the disk or USB device with. Now it'll come up asking if you want to install it or try it, and we want to try it because if you have an existing version of Windows that you're just trying it out with, then obviously you're trying it. If you're trying to recover your files, you also want to choose try it because we don't want to overwrite your files that you have there. And when we choose try it, it's just going to run the operating system off the USB device. Once it's booted off the USB, if it's booted into it successfully, you'll have your Linux operating system up and running. And if you use Xubuntu, which I have in this case, it'll look exactly like my screen, maybe a little bit different if it's a newer version. But if it's Xubuntu, this is the style of it. So you'll see there's a trash in your file system, which is the Linux temporary file system. That's not your actual files. It's a home folder. There's the install if you decided you want to install this afterwards. But then there should be another drive that looks like this one. In this case, because I'm running this off a virtual machine, I don't have another one that has that icon. But it would have a different name on there. It may say the name of the drive, how it was labeled as. So if you go into that, you'll open up the file manager, and you're going to see a series of folders within that. Now, I just created a dummy here, so there'll be a lot more than what you see here. But the important thing, what you're going to be looking for, is a folder called Users. And when you go in there, you're going to see probably quite a few of them. There'll be the public one, which will have shared documents, shared desktop, videos, all those different folders that are shared. So you might want to copy that. And then the admin folder, where you can go in there and you'll see your desktop, documents, music, pictures, videos, all that stuff. So you can copy all of those things as well. Now, you are booting off a USB drive to be able to do this. So you're going to need another USB, possibly, unless you have enough space on this one. But it would be ideal if you can have another USB drive you plug in. And then you can copy these and paste them onto that other USB stick. So we're going to plug in another USB stick to copy this over to. Because I'm using a virtual machine to show you this, the actual USB drive I plugged in didn't show up. But in your case, you would see the USB drive, and again, it will look a little different, that will show up, and you'll just open that up. We can drag this over, and we can resize things or just snap it to the side just like it does in Windows. Open the Windows folder, and now you have them both side by side. So you could literally grab this, right click, copy, and then grab it over here, right click, and paste. And now you have an exact copy of all of your stuff over on that other USB drive. And that's basically it. You've just backed up all of your data. If you'd like to learn a little bit more about Linux, let me know in the comments below. Your feedback is really important to me and helped me to have ideas for making more videos, tutorials for you, and your questions, comments as well help me and make it all worthwhile. So give it a like if you enjoyed this video, subscribe if you haven't already, ring the bell so you're notified every time we come out with a new video, which is at least once a week. Although we're not going deeper in this video on how to use Linux, it was really just to show you how to get your files back, but I can make a lot more videos on Linux and how to use it and some of the different ones out there. So let me know what you think in the comments below, and we will see you guys in the next video. Bye for now.